In yesterday's lecture, we have started one new chapter, that is measurement of matter. In that chapter, we have discussed various laws of chemical combination. In those laws, we have seen law of chemical combination, and after that, we have seen law of conservation of matter. Today, we are going to see atom in detail. Before starting with our main point, that is atom, we will discuss with some questions. Our first question is, from which experiment was it discovered that atoms have an internal structure? As we all know, an experiment performed by Sir J.J. Thomson in 1887 has concluded that atoms have their internal structure. And this experiment was performed in 1887. Our next question is, what are the two parts of an atom and what are they made up of? As we all know, atom is made up of two parts. Its first part is nucleus, which contains protons as well as neutrons, and its second part is called as extranuclear part. In that extranuclear part, orbits are present, and in those orbits, electrons are continuously revolving. So we can say that electron has two different parts. First is nucleus and second is extranuclear part. In this atom, the electrons are negatively charged elementary particles which revolve in their respective orbits, and this part of an atom is called as extranuclear part. As you can see on the screen, electrons are revolving around the nucleus, which contains protons and neutrons. Protons are denoted by blue colored element, blue colored structure, and neutrons are expressed by red colored structure. Now we can say that size of an atom is determined by its radius. As we all know, the atomic radius of an atom is the distance between its nucleus and its outermost orbit, and it is generally expressed in nanometers. These atoms are very, very tiny in their size, so we require modern instruments like microscopes, such as electron microscope, field ion microscope, scanning tunneling microscope. Such modern instruments are used to observe an atom. Out of these modern instruments, as we can see on the screen, there is an image of a field ion microscope of iridium atom. If we look at the image of an atom obtained with the field ion microscope, on the screen we can see that every speck on that image is representing an iridium atom. The size of an atom is determined by its radius. As we can see on the screen, the relation between meter and nanometer is given. As we all know, 1 meter is equal to 10 to the power plus 9 nanometers. As we can see, the approximate size of an atom is given on the screen. For hydrogen atom, its approximate atomic radius is 10 to the power minus 10 meters. For a water molecule, its atomic radius will be 10 to the power minus 9 meters. And for an hemoglobin molecule, its atomic radius will be 10 to the power minus 8 meter. In this way, the atomic radius varies according to the molecules and atoms of different elements. Now, atoms are very small particles, and modern instruments like field ion microscope, scanning tunneling microscope have the capacity to show enlarged images of an atom. The atomic size depends on the number of electrons present in the orbit of that atom. The greater the number of orbits, the larger will be the size. As we can see, the atom of potassium is bigger than atom of sodium. If two atoms have the same outermost orbit, then the atom having larger number of electrons in the outermost orbit is the smaller than one having fewer electrons in the same outermost orbit. So this was a very important point from the exam point of view. All of you should remember this point. For example, an atom of magnesium is smaller than atom of sodium. Now we will move towards our next point, that is mass of an atom. As we all know, the mass of an atom is completely concentrated in its nucleus. That means if we want to calculate mass of an atom, then we have to focus upon its nucleus. The mass of an atom is due to its protons and neutrons which are present inside its nucleus. As we can see on the screen, protons and neutrons are present in the nucleus, and the sum of number of protons along with neutrons will give atomic mass. Protons and neutrons are together called as nucleons. An atom is a very, very tiny particle, as we all know. So for determining the mass of an atom, it was very difficult task for the scientists also. So these scientists later on came up with one idea, and in that idea they have proposed one concept of relative mass. In this concept of relative mass, a reference atom was required for expressing the relative mass of an atom. So, scientists have considered hydrogen as the reference atom. As we all know, hydrogen contains only one electron and one proton, and hydrogen do not contain any neutron. So, the atomic mass of an hydrogen atom will be equal to 1. Now we are going to see atomic mass of a nitrogen atom. Mass of a nitrogen atom is 14, and it can be calculated by adding the number of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus of nitrogen. This is how the relative atomic masses of various elements were determined. On this scale, the relative atomic masses of many electron elements came out to be fractional. For example, hydrogen, it is 1.007. Finally, in 1961, the carbon atom was selected as the reference atom, and its mass was considered to be 12.011. which is approximately equal to 12. Also, the relative atomic mass of one hydrogen atom was compared with the carbon atom, and the mass of a carbon atom was calculated, and it was found to be 12. The relative atomic masses of some elements are given in the chart, as you can see on the screen. For hydrogen, its atomic mass is 1. For helium, its atomic mass is 4. For lithium, its atomic mass is 7. For beryllium, it's 9. For boron, it's 11. For carbon, it is 12. For nitrogen, it is 14, and so on. Along with this, some elements like chlorine have fractional atomic masses. As we can see on the screen, chlorine has atomic mass which is equal to 30.35.5. So these are some exceptions. You have to remember these examples. I request all of you to note down this table in your notebook. So, from this table, we will revise our concept of atomic mass. An atomic mass is nothing but the mass of an atom, which is the sum of number of protons and neutrons present inside the nucleus of an atom. And as we have stated earlier, the mass of an atom is always concentrated at its nucleus.